You know I don't find that amusing.
It wasn't meant to amuse, but to prod you to hurry. It's midday already. You promised Ciri you'd train with her. Go before Vesemir bores her to death with those etchings.
So, later then.
See you later.
You're running out of juice.
I know. You might bring me some more once you're done training.
Shit. Mountain pass as beautiful as ever. Nothing but silver.
Gold clashes with my complexion. You should know that.
Got any clothes that aren't black or white?
Undergarments.
Witcher's fast asleep. Ciri's disappeared somewhere, of course. Guess she prefers practice to theory.
Why?
Time to wake up, Master. These lessons so boring they put you to sleep too?
Damn it. Better taking notes on ghouls and owl ghouls. Wanted to rest my eyes a bit.
Making her slog through that brick? No wonder she took off.
John of Bruges lacks flair, true, but he's reliable. Not like the hogwash they print nowadays. She's tackling the pendulums, right? How many times do I have to tell her? Don't train alone. It only embeds your errors. Bring our young damsel to the lower courtyard. She wants to practice, she'll get to practice.
Gotta admit, we've spoiled her.
We've spoiled her. I've been saying it from the start. Ciri needs a firm hand.
Been saying that true. But you let her walk all over you just like the rest of us do.
Fine. I suppose I'm partly to blame. But this has to end. Now. Killing monsters is not something to be taken lightly. Ciri must understand that if she's to become one of us. I'll see you below.
Wrong. Now I see why you were so eager to practice. Strike. Pirouette. Wrong. Footwork. Enough. Get down.
With a flip?
What do you think? All right. Take off the blindfold. You've got work to do. Your reflexes are still slow.
Maybe for a Witcher.
Think drowners or striggers will go easy on you because you haven't undergone the mutations? Though in your shoes, I'd fear Vesemir more than any strigger. Disobeying his instructions? Unwise.
Well, yes, but that book was horribly dull.
I know, and you know that's no excuse.
I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
Better not. Vesemir said if it does, he'll make you eat a bowl of slugs covered in salt.
You!
Exactly. So you'd best behave. Come on, we'll practice with the others down below.
Shall we run the walls?
Of course. It's a Witcher school or an elven bathhouse?
You to the bottom.
Maybe if you fall. About breathing through your mouth in rhythm with your steps. Ciri, cut it out.
Anything to say for yourself, young lady?
I'm very sorry, Uncle Vesemir.
Young blood craves action, I understand that. But when you fight a beast, knowledge counts as much as your silver sword. At the very least, you ought to be able to tell a ghoul from an owl ghoul.
By markings, like unto the panthera tigris that in Zeracania dwells, and by the sickly paleness of its visage.
So you did. Read the chapter. Still, you should have asked if...
But you were asleep, Uncle Vesemir.
So you did the reading. Why not admit it right off?
Never pounce on an advantage as soon as it appears. Wait till it stands to have maximum effect. Uncle Vesemir's words.
Well, you're a quick study. Quick, but mischievous. Fine, we've talked enough. Geralt, you're with me, Lambert with Eskel, Ciri with a dummy.
Again?
Stop groaning and grab a sword. What do you think? Should we start by reviewing the fundamentals or go right to free training?
Should work on the basics. Even skilled masters need to hone the fundamentals, and Ciri's barely a novice.
Draw your sword, Geralt! Quick cut! 1, 2, 3! Strong strike now. Give it all you got. Never lock your elbow when striking, young lady.
What now?
That! Slice the jugular!
Stop! Position, Ciri. Footwork. Remember.
Strike.
Maybe a storm's too old for this shit.
Take that! Sliced your jugular!
Now, young lady, to bring the day to a close, we'll go over a few witcher's signs. Let's start with Quen. Ciri, Quen is sometimes called the Witcher's Shield. Now watch carefully to see why. Cast Igni, Geralt. I want to see sparks fly. If not for the Quen sign, I'd be a flame buck. All right, Geralt, come on. See that, Ciri? Ard will knock anyone or anything off balance. Destroy their rhythm. Time for Axie. Damn it, I hate this feeling. Axie can really muddle your mind. Erden now. Show her, girl. See this, Ciri? Couldn't move if I wanted. Throw a bomb. Don't worry, Ciri. Quen will dampen the blow. Thank you. Fine. Enough. Continue training at will.
Whoa. You really showed him, kid.
Siri, get down here.
A little she-devil. Soon as she's back, we'll set her to polishing all the swords at Kaer Morhen.
Find that helmet. Siri? I'll make sure to find every last blade for you.
You all right?
Had a nightmare.
About?
Take forever to explain.
Dawn, some way off. We've got time.
Started in the guest room at Kaer Morhen. I was relaxing in the tub, and next to me...
Triss?
Yennefer. Funny, isn't it? She's never been there. Seemed so real in my dream, though.
Was she nagging you about something? True to life, indeed. We'll find her.
I know we will. That's not what worries me. You've seen her tracks. She's at full gallop all the time. Breakneck speed through wild lands, devastated battlefields. She's in a hurry to get somewhere, or fleeing something. Either way, it means trouble of some sort.
Be surprised if she wasn't in trouble. She's always poked her nose in beehives. Courtly intrigues here, mages' conspiracies there. What do you expect?
Don't know. Guess I thought once we were finally reunited, things would be calm. At least for a while.
Calm? With Yennefer? Good luck.
In the dream, I went and found Siri. Then we trained.
Those were the days. Little she-devil. I've trained kids who were faster, stronger, but none had her character. Didn't end well, did it, your dream?
No. A wild hunt appeared, attacked Siri. I couldn't move, stood there like a stump.
It was just a dream.
That's the problem. It was more. In the past, when Siri'd appear in my dreams, something was wrong. She was in danger.
We taught her how to defend herself from anything, wraiths included.
Be dawning soon. Time to go.
Wait. Show me the letter from Yennefer. Might have overlooked some hint in there.
Didn't overlook anything. We were meant to meet in Willoughby. That's what she wrote. Meanwhile, one army or another burned the village to the ground. All we can do is follow our trail, so...
Stop talking for a minute and give me the letter. How about that? It does smell of lilac and gooseberries.
You were gonna read it, not sniff it.
We must meet. Soon. Willoughby near Vizima. Nothing else to guide us there. What's this postscript? I still have the unicorn?
That's private. Very private.
Aha. I understand. At least I think I do. Maybe not entirely, but perhaps that's for the best.
Back on topic. How's it look? How far behind Yennefer are we?
2 or 3 days. Trail's fresh. But it looks like it leads towards the main road. Could be muddled there. Wait, hear that?
I hear it. I smell it. Ghouls.
At them!
Past necrophages follow. Let's go before any more show up.
Skull in black crystal. Why do I think this is Yen's? Ever tell you about this sorcerer I knew? Couldn't stop talking about how useful they are as creatures.
Because you can brew potions from their blood?
No, because by eating rotting corpses they prevent epidemics.
Did he know they eat the living as well?
No, really upset him too. His theory collapsed.
War is not exactly going our way.
We have a side.
The Northern Realms.
Radovid's realms, don't you mean? Temeria and Edirne are no more.
Radovid's pledged to restore the old borders as soon as he wins the war.
Believe that?
Gotta believe something. That's what keeps us going. Going?
Help me! Help! Has it gone?
Yeah. Come out.
gods, that was close. I was sure I'd end up like my mare.
Provided you got lucky.
Your horse died quickly, but griffins like to toy with their prey. Eat it, alive, piece by piece.
Oh. You'd like a reward, I suppose.
Could always use a few crowns.
Thing is, I've a meager purse at the moment. Nilfgaardians requisitioned my goods. Now this? Here.
Back to the trail.
Like I said, leads to the main road and ends there, muddled.
You seek someone?
Yes, a woman. Medium height, long black hair. Seen anyone like that?
No, but there's an inn here in White Orchard. Sole one around. Gets its share of travelers. Perhaps you'll learn something there?
Not a bad idea, especially since that wound needs cleaning.
Ah, beast barely grazed me. But sure, could use a good rye, nice and cool, you know, straight from a cellar.
Let's go. So, a griffin this close to the village? Strange.
My thoughts exactly. In the forest or the mountain, sure, but here? And near the main road.
Maybe it's the war. Corpses everywhere, the stench of blood, burnt flesh. Drives monsters crazy sometimes.
Men, too. We need to watch ourselves in White Orchard. And we should leave as soon as we learn anything.
Run, Roach.
What?
Take that down before there's trouble.
That is a coat of arms, the Temerian lilies. They've a right to hang there.
This ain't Temeria no more, old man. It's Nilfgaard now.
My arse it is.
Witches. I'll not drink with Weaverlaw's freaks.
Beg your pardon for those thugs.
No need. We're used to it.
Folk are jumpy around here. Armies just passed through. Now a griffin's prowling about.
Mm-hmm. Already had the pleasure. One mean beast.
Mean? Light way for a hunter to put it. Clawed Lena so bad, poor thing's one foot in the grave. But there's no good to wallow in misfortune. How can I be of service?
With a drop of vodka for me.
And you? Something to wet your tongue.
Busy place you got.
Nations on the move. Some search for kin, others just want to get out of the way of the armies. They all need food, drink, and a night's rest in warmth.
So, war's been good for your trade?
Aye, so far. But it'd be best to know peace again. Times like these, you never know what tomorrow will bring.
There a contract on that griffin?
Nay, not at the moment. Used to be. Soon as a beast had built a nest nearby, the alderman would start a collection, or go to the Lord for help. Now the aldermen don't use the privy without asking the Black One's permission first. And seems they hanged the Lord. So no contract.
Shame. We might have done something, but not for free.
Show me what you got behind the counter. Looking for a woman. Raven-haired, violet eyes, dresses in black and white, riding in from Willoughby. And, strange as it sounds, lilac and gooseberries might have smelled that.
I've not seen nor smelt such a lady. Believe I'd remember.
Yeah, especially hard to forget this one.
Plenty of travellers about, though. Folk from all over. Might be worth your while to ask after her.
Thanks for everything. Help you bandage that up?
Please. I'm not decrepit yet.
Then I'll ask about Yennefer.
Mm-hmm. Just remember, we'd rather not draw any attention.
Here, Black One's been out measuring the fields.
Let him measure. Better that than burning the harvest.
Oh, Drommel. Drommel, you're dumber than a headless cockerel. Why are they marking out them lines, eh? Parcel out their patrimony. Give it to their own.
More. There are four factions.
Four what?
Factions, teams, suits. What a waste of time. The Earth shall revolve around the sun before you comprehend these rules.
Got a minute?
Why not? Aldert Geert, assistant professor in contemporary history at Oxenfurt Academy.
Geralt of Rivia, witcher with tenure. I'm looking for a woman, long hair, dressed in black and white. Seen anyone like that?
Of course not. Unlike the populace, I know the horsewoman of war is pure poppycock.
Horsewoman of war? What's that about?
Folks say an omen. A beautiful phantom rides the fields at night, looks as you described her. Armies follow her, and all who cross her path meet with misfortune.
I can vouch for the last bit. Know where they saw her?
No, facts interest me, not fairy tales.
Not a place I'd ever expect to find a scholar. Take it you're fleeing the war?
Quite the opposite. Chasing it. I'm headed for the front.
Tired of life?
I seek knowledge, which I value more than life itself. I've a thirst no dusty old tomes can quench. I wish to see the Nilfgaardian invasion with my own eyes, understand it, and record it all in my chronicle, my magnum opus.
Take my advice. Go back to your books while you can. War's no game. No faculty meetings to attend, no tenure to gain, end notes to compile. First soldier you see will kill you.
Why would he do that? Me? A neutral civilian? A scholar?
boots.
Come again?
He'll kill you for your boots. War reached Novigrad yet?
Nope, but it's only a matter of time. Nilfgaard on one bank, Redania on the other. Drooling over the city like dogs over a juicy bone.
Many a ruler's choked on that bone.
True. We value our liberty in Novigrad, and we know how to fight for it.
The scholars especially.
The sword is not the only weapon. Do not forget, architects from our academy designed the city walls. Walls no war machine has ever crumbled.
Gotta go. So long.
A moment, Witcher. You strike me as a man of the world. Are you familiar with Gwent?
No, and I don't have time to learn.
But the rules are quite simple. Come, let's play.
Why not?
Splendid! Here's how it's done. you've a knack for this game. If you ever find yourself in Oxenfurt and wish to play a true master, ask for Stepan. A simple innkeep by trade, but a true maestro when it comes to Gwent.
I'll remember that. Thanks. Looking for a woman.
Like everyone.
Not like everyone. And not just any woman. Mine smells of lilac and gooseberries, dresses in black and white.
Two schnappsies. It'll lift your spirits.
Finding her, that'll lift my spirits.
You look haggard. It's just a few drops to improve your mood. A little schnappsies never hurt a soul.
Can we cut to the chase? You seen her or not?
Yennefer of Vengerberg.
Never mentioned her name?
Yet you described her perfectly. And once I hear something, I never forget. Can't help it.
What do you do? Who are you?
A mangy vagrant. Gaunt or Odin, at your service.
Vagrant? That a profession now?
Once a merchant of mirrors. The madding crowd dubbed me Master Mirror, or the Man of Glass.
How do you know Yennefer?
What a question. Master Dandelion's ballads, of course. The only way a humble merchant might hope to rub up against greatness. Unless, that is, he's as lucky as I am.
And runs into a very patient witcher.
It's a Geralt of Rivia himself. The Butcher of Blaviken.
Recognize me from Master Dandelion's ballads, too?
To your health.
You seen Yennefer?
Deepest apologies, but I must ask. Is this about love?
Guessed it. It's love.
I knew it at once.
What do you know? Tell me.
Before you appeared, it never occurred to me that might have been Yennefer. Who would have thought?
Get to the point.
An Ilf Guardian scout from the local garrison saw her.
Where?
At their camp. She rode in there. Dark of night. Black and white. Gooseberries and... Yes, I know. Had a terse exchange with the garrison commander and raced off.
Where to?
I'm not omniscient. Ask at the garrison.
Thanks.
We men of the road must stick together. Perhaps one day I'll be in trouble and you'll be nearby to help.
Yes? What is it, Wolf?
See you later, Vesemir. I'm looking for someone.
And we seek some peace and quiet.
Out of my face, freak, for your breath sours my beer.
Just want to talk.
You deaf, Stray. No one here will talk to you.
If it's company you seek, stick that mangy snout of yours in a trough with the pigs.
Show that shit eater, Micah.
Red-haired woman dressed in black and white. Seen her? Talk.
Folks say the lady rode through the village a few days back. Galloping so fast she knocked Radabor into a ditch.
Which way did she go?
I don't know. Lots of tracks leading off the main road. Could have gone anywhere.
Oi, people! The freak's taken Micah's mind!
Uh-huh. And I'll take your tongue if you don't shut up.
Done drinking.
Mm-hmm.
Then fuck off.
Don't want your kind here.
I haven't done anything to you, so just calm down.
Of course not. You done nothing.
Horses working witchcraft. Get him!
Not your lucky day. Nice meeting you. Take it easy.
It's Durban now. D-E-R-V-A-N. Not Voidemort.
You should tell the black one.
It's raining, it's pouring, and Vermeer is roaring. He bumped his head when he went to bed and wet himself the morning.
Freak.
Come on.
You say? Who taught you that?
Chitty!
Now listen carefully. You're never to sing that rhyme again. Never. And you're not to play with Chitty no more. Chetty's a little fool and get us all killed.